One day, you are going to be TJ Maxx obsessed as I am. Some people look down on TJ Maxx products, and it's okay for me because I have more chances to find great ones. Today's video is all about ones that are worth buying. I am not going to say favorite because I have way too many. You can probably find them at TJ Maxx stores, online, Marshalls, and sometimes at Nordstrom Rack, but I find that Nordstrom prices are slightly higher for the same items. Worst case scenario, you still get to know some brands that either you haven't heard before, have heard before, but never purchased from. Pretty much everything you may need to know about a brand. Do I need one more white dress? Absolutely not, but white dresses will always be the choice for the summer. I was skeptical about this one, but I really wanted a different style other than square neck. This is by Young, Broke, and Fabulous, the same brand that I bought my super cute cover up in my previous video. My favorite part about this dress is that you can wear it as scoop neck or off the shoulders, belt or unbelted. It does have pockets, but they are quite hidden, so which is nice because they don't make the dress bulky. The bottom portion is lined, so you are good there, but the upper half is not. I tried it first with nippies, but you could see my headlights, so a strapless bra is probably the best choice. It is long. I wore it with 2-inch slides that graced the floors. The pattern is quite subtle, almost like a window pane. It is 100% cotton in size extra small and worth $39.99. Last time I checked, they also have a black one on the website. This is probably not a bag that I wear often in the summer days, but I love the brand Arcadia. I have a few bags by them, but have given away over the years because of the practicality. I bought it because I didn't want to miss out on a good bag at a great price, $99.99. It is bigger than a lot of shoulder bags that I own and is 100% leather. It has very subtle pattern, and your fingerprints probably show more on this if you are sweaty, but it is very easy to wipe off. The red edge is almost their signature thing, so it is subtle that it won't clash with most outfit colors you wear. I love that diamond kind of lock, and as you know, I almost prefer gold hardware over silver ones. It even has the authenticity label inside. I can't wait to wear more in the winter. I wasn't sure about this one either, but this one proves that sometimes you just have to try it on. It caught me by surprise. My husband approved this one off the bat. You all know I don't have much of a waistline anymore, but this one gives me a little bit of shape, and my aunt thinks it is also flattering. The floral pattern is a little more muted, but it is still romantic. I especially love the adjustable shoulder ties and the ruffle sweetheart neckline. It has a small zipper back and tiered ruffles on the bottom, and it is by O.P.T in size extra small for $39.99. It's still available on the website. The material is polyester, but I don't mind it at all. The dress is quite lovely, so I can totally overlook the fabric. It makes me think of a mimosa Sunday brunch for some reason. If you watch my shoes collection video, you would know I talked about my white slides by Steven. This style has been popular for a few years now, and I was going to buy similar ones by BP at Nordstrom, but the reviews were bad, so imagine how happy I was to find these at TJ Maxx. These are in size 6.5, slightly small for my feet, but with leather stretching over time, I think they are better than the next size, which is 7.5. I paid under $30 for these. I absolutely love them. They are so comfortable from the get-go. No breaking in whatsoever. Not sure if you can tell, but there is a croc pattern, and coincidentally matches the pattern on my black bag that I wore that day. I would buy them in brown if I can find them in TJ Maxx again. Eyelet is another pattern that I am quite obsessed with. You've seen me wearing a few. This one looks really cute with denim shorts, denim jeans, or white on white. I love it when a garment looks like dressed up instantly without actual accessories. There is a long row of buttons in the back, so it is a lot easier to put on. I would wear it with my nude bra, but if you are not comfortable with the holes, wear a nude or beige camisole and size up for that option. Another reason eyelets are nice in the summer is that the pattern allows a lot of air flowing in and out. I often wear my top tucked in, but a pattern like this one can be worn untucked in my opinion. I've been wanting to buy a bucket bag, but hadn't found one at the right price, size, or look. I am in love with this one. It's straw, it's bucket. I have so many bags in similar shape, so it is quite nice for a change with this shape. It is Italian made and is $70. It has two pockets inside, one zipper compartment, and this is where you use to open and close the bag. This kind of bag does lose its shape or fullness, so I stuff it with papers or towels inside when not in use. The size is perfect for me. When you are petite, you do think about proportion more. Love it. Another one from TJ Maxx that really caught me by surprise, it is linen. And you know I'm like obsessed with linen. It looked really big in person, so I didn't even bother trying it on. It was $39.99 by House of Hollow. This is the same brand that I got my gray jacket for $60, which was a really good buy as well. So it's quite long on me, and it has a slit on the side, which I really love on long dresses. Also on the top, it has this elastic to keep the shoulders up, I guess. It's very modest type of dress, but it's not stuffy by any means. The square neck is also modern. Here's the back of it. I wore this to the mall with my family last week when they came to visit, and we walked into a Kate Spade store. First thing the sales lady said to me was, "Let me guess, your dress is from Reformation." I was flattered because Reformation is a really quality, sustainable brand. Meghan Markle is famous for wearing their brand. Sure enough, I found a dress almost identical to this one for $245. I am the kind of person who would wear long sleeve clothing even in summer because I'm always cold, and it doesn't wrinkle much so far, even though it was shuffled in a plastic bag when I bought it. Speaking of linen, if you plan on buying linen bedding from TJ Maxx, go with Stone and Beam instead of Pure Linen brand. I have both, and the former is softer and seems to have a better quality. Everyone who has seen these shoes love them. I don't have them now because I sent them back for exchange for a larger size. These are not the most comfortable shoes in my collection, but I love the height and the style. They feel a tad heavy for me and are probably not great for walking, but they are really, really cute. They are almost like flip-flops, just more elevated. These are by Avellini for $39.99 and in size 6.5. I felt that 7.5 would look better on me. That is why I exchanged them. They still have these shoes on the website as of today, so check them out. By the way, TJ Maxx has a made in Italy category, so it should be quicker to find them. I don't really have good clips showing this dress because it is two sizes larger than I normally wear, but it is another linen that screams Ralph Lauren vibe to me. It is only $29.99, V-neck with pockets, slits on both sides, and the length falls at my knees, so it is a shorter dress. The pattern and fabric were the reasons I bought it. I will have to find it at another TJ Maxx for a smaller size though. I am not too crazy about the sleeves, but I can wear a blazer over if need to. By the way, this is by Jones New York. I don't think I have linen dress in stripes, so it is a nice addition to my summer wardrobe. I like this one for its price, $24, and its size and color. Some straw bags look too dark for the summer to me, and some are scratchy and will scratch your clothes when the bag is worn against them. This is very soft. Not sure if I like the pom-pom thingy here, but I can easily remove them. This is by Savannah. I am sure I've heard of that brand before, but this is my first purchase from that brand. This is not big enough for beach towels, but big enough to fit quite a bit. Being in the healthcare sector, a lot of white shirt dresses look like old nurse uniforms to me, so I was happy that this one is in pink stripe. It is more A-line than a lot of shirt dresses I've seen. This easily channels Jackie Kennedy vibe. I also like the ties on the sleeves. I love details that set it apart from others but remain classic. This one was $13 and in size medium, so it feels loose but not frumpy. It was the only size available, so I took a chance on it. It is a little thin for my liking. I think a slip dress is needed because I would be too conscious of my panties showing, even in nude. For that price, I can afford a slip dress to go under for sure. Someone need to stop me from collecting more straw bags. This will be my fifth or sixth one so far. This one stands out because of the sage green trims and the tortoise buckle here. It is very well made for only $19.99. It is vegan friendly and lead safe, whatever that means. The brand is Itzy and Ally. There are two pockets inside and the size is exactly what I typically go for. I like to wear this with my all white outfit, a white dress. I haven't played much with it, but with it being straw material, it will go quite well with a lot of pieces. Don't you think it looks more expensive?